एक उपस्थित पोको लेके मोरे हुबेसा जोनाइसो एकुल साइंकक उत्तर पूर्व ग्रंदा मेलार गुवाहाटी हुआ उद्बोधन कोरी बोले पाए मोय अजी अत्यंता होकी लगोते ये अनुष्ठानते अहम हाहित्य हबाय अकबरुवा वैष्णव पंडित सिसिर चंद्रबोर बारुवा अवार्ड प्रदान करर ओजोग पोवार भवे मोय उटिकोई आनंदितो माय डियर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स आई एम सॉरी आई कांट स्पीक टू यूर ब्यूटिफुल लैंग्वेज बट आई अंडरस्टैंड बिकॉज देयर इज अ संस्कृत लिंक आल्सो टू द लैंग्वेज एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द वर्ड्स आर फेमिलियर सो आई कुड अंडरस्टैंड and moreover it's easy for the people to understand any speech in their mother tongue that's why I was telling Sarbanand ji that he should speak in his mother tongue because if he speak in English I may understand few people may understand but if he speak in Assami all the Assami people they'll be happy and they will understand better my dear brothers and sisters I am really delighted to be present at the grand opening of the 21st Northeast Book Fair being held under the aegis of all Assam publishers and booksellers association in the beautiful city of Guwahati. When this invitation was received, my people told me, sir, protocol wise it's a small function and moreover it's a regular activity. Every year they do it. For the Vice President of India to go all the way, I said, this is being held in Guwahati in the Northeast. And moreover, the cause is very good. That's why we should definitely go there. That's why I came here for this function today. I extend my heartiest congratulations to the organizers of this mega book fair. I'm also glad to have presented the award of Vaishnava Sachi Chandraboro, instituted by Assam Sahitya Sabha, the prestigious literary and socio-cultural forum of Assam, to Sri Jayant Borua, Chairman cum Managing Director Sadhin Pratidin. I congratulate Sri Jayant Varwa on winning this coveted award. Assam Sahitya Sabha is a very important literary organization in the country and it has produced many stalwarts in our literature. I am happy to know that the Northeast Book Fair, also known as the People's Book Fair, because of the popularity and support it enjoys among the people of this region, is one of the largest book fairs of the region. I am told that the focal theme of the book fair is missing tribes and that the book fair is dedicated to the memory of Tabu Rab Tate, an eminent scholar, a distinguished educationist and a brilliant researcher. I am glad to note that the Northeast Book Fair since its inception has been striving hard to popularize the culture, literature, heritage and ethnic tribes of the 7 states of the Northeastern region. Assam, the very mention of this name brings to one's mind the delightful blend of culture, heritage, faith and beliefs of the myriad ethnic tribes and sub-tribes residing in this region. The natural beauty of the state, it's a soulful music, it's buoyant literature, it's a delectable cuisine and its stunning art forms are all interwoven into social fabric and permeate all barriers of caste, creed and religion. Blessed by the Kamakya Devi, this beautiful land, a title paradise, but a little paradise which has a title, on a rocky terrain is the land of Srimanta Sankaradeva, the father of Assami culture, who was a saint, scholar, poet, playwright, social, religious reformer. The 22 sutras founded by Sankaradeva ji for propagation of Vaishnavite religion and culture are still thriving in the Trini Riverine Islands of Mazori, another natural wonder of the state. This is also the land of Lakshminath Bezborua, the celebrated pioneer of modern Assami literature. Jyoti Prasad Agarwala, noted Assami playwright, lyricist poet, writer, and filmmaker. Considered as an Assamese cultural icon, Dr. Bhupen Hazarika, genius, lyricist, musician, singer, poet, filmmaker, widely known as Shuddha Kanta, who was honored with the Bharat Ratna posthumously, and many more such iconic personalities of this region. This book fair being held today is a befitting tribute to Assam's love for language, literature, and culture. And I am confident that the book lovers of the region will collectively make this fair a resounding success. My dear sisters and brothers, we are a civilization that since time immemorial accorded divine status to letter, a status equivalent to that God. India's twist with the books and literature is almost as old as 5,000 years old civilization itself. We always consider it of paramount importance to record knowledge. What is book? Book is a record of the knowledge. The Harappan people knew how to write. Unfortunately, their script has not been deciphered. Sanskrit dominated, first in its Vedic, later in its classified form in Indian literature. From the Vedas, which are the most ancient forms of literature in India, to our great epics Ramayana and Mahabharata, to our scientific texts like Charaka Samhita, Aryabhartiya, Bhatiya, we have had a repository of astounding wealth of the written word. India represents the largest democracy with a seamless picture of diversity and unity, perhaps unparalleled anywhere in the world. India's physical, ethnic, and linguistic variety is as staggering as its cultural pluralism, which exists in a framework of interconnectedness. Vividata me ekata Bharat ka viseshata. Alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh. This is the beauty of this land. We have more than 760 thriving languages. In fact, we had thousands of languages earlier. These languages, they present the beauty of Indian culture and heritage. We must propagate, promote, protect our mother tongue. That's why I suggest to the people, particularly younger generation, to focus more on reading in mother tongue, promoting mother tongue. Ghar mein, aapas mein, baatcheet karte samay, matru bhasha mein hi bolna chahiye. और पड़ोसी के साथ भी मातृभाषा में बोलना चाहिए मैं किसी अन्य भाषा का विरोध नहीं करता हूं आई एम नॉट अगेंस्ट एनी अदर लैंग्वेज यू लर्न एज मेनी लैंग्वेजेस पॉसिबल इफ यू वांट टू लर्न चाइनीज आल्सो आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम सो दैट यू कैन कन्वे देम अबाउट आवर कल्चर एंड हेरिटेज आल्सो बट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू मस्ट फोकस ऑन मदर टंग दैट्स व्हाई आई मेड इट अ पॉइंट अ मिशन इन माय लाइफ एंड ड्यूरिंग दिस वाइस प्रेसिडेंट टेन्योर Wherever I go, I am insisting, and government, state governments must have the administration in mother tongue only, number one. Number two, you can go for Hindi, you can go for English, you can go for other languages, no problem. We have so many languages in this country. But people's language has to be promoted and protected. That's why I say mother tongue is like your eyesight. Other language is like spectacles. If you have eyesight, spectacles will give you more sight. And then book reading will give you additional foresight. So mother tongue gives you sight and book reading will give you foresight. So better we respect both. From ancient Indian literature to contemporary forms, India has been still is home to hundreds of talented writers and gifted poets. And I am sure that this legacy of literary brilliance will be kept alive by generations of writers to come. My dear sisters and brothers, books are informative, illuminative, and inspiring, and they are best companions, counselors, and change agents. Books help widen our horizon, our understanding, our knowledge. The more we read books, the more we understand the world around us and discover life beyond what we have already known. Reading enhances our knowledge, skills, and develop fluency, allow us to express our thoughts and ideas better, and hence we become much better communicators. Books quench our thirst for knowledge. Through books, we comprehend history understand different cultures and lifestyles and even learn new languages. Books open your mind to new ideas. Reading also keeps one's brain healthy, very healthy, by improving our cognitive function and memory. It helps improve focus and aids the development of analytical skills. Books have the power to inspire and to motivate us with the stories of people who have fought against odds to succeed, whether it is the journey of a fictionary character or the real-life achievements of historical figures. Books encourage us to stay positive and keep moving forward. Books have the power to stir our creativity and stimulate innovative and incentive and inventive ideas. My dear sisters and brothers, the library movement that flourished in different parts of the nation has played a critical role in the socio-cultural renaissance of India. In addition to spreading literacy and education, our public libraries also played a part in safeguarding democracy, in promoting peace, culture, and brotherhood. Even in the freedom movement also, the libraries, they have played an important role. From Andhra Pradesh to Punjab, to Maharashtra to Kerala, the library movement swept the length of a breadth of the country, bringing light of learning and knowledge to the darkest corners of the nation. We must keep the legacy of the library movement alive. I strongly believe that for the society's benefit from books, there is a need to have one library for every village. Har gaam mein grandhalay hona bahut jaruri hai. Grandhalay aur devalay. Ye bhi bahut jaruri hai. Devalay mane keval Hindu devataon ka aisa nahi. Devalay mane prardhanalay. Jisme aapko viswas hai wo aisi prardhanalay hona chahiye. Prardhana karne se aapko swastata hoga. Aapko buddhi vikasit hoga. Sanmarg, sadachar, sat pravartan. आप सीख पाएंगे इसलिए ग्रंथालय हर एक गांव में होना चाहिए ये सरकार का काम है और समाज का काम है हर गांव में ग्रंथालय प्रोत्साहन करना चाहिए और साथ ही साथ देवालय लोग अपना अपना इच्छा के अनुसार अभीष्ट के अनुसार ऐसी प्रार्थनालय को स्थापना करने से लोग शाम को थोड़ी देर वहां जाके बैठ के आपस में चर्चा करके सामूहिक चिंतन करके और उनको स्वस्थता भी मिलेगा और सही मार्गदर्शन मिलेगा और सद्बुद्ध भी प्राप्त करेगा इसलिए मेरा विश्वास है देश में गांव गांव में ग्रंथालय होना चाहिए और ये देवालय प्रार्थनालय भी होना बहुत जरूरी है और साथ ही साथ मित्रों हर एक गांव में मैं और एक विषय पर जोड़ना चाहता हूँ एक सेवालय भी होना चाहिए जो वंचित लोग है जो पीड़ित लोग है जो गरीब लोग है असहाय लोग गए निसहाय लोग गए उनका मदद करने के लिए गांव में समाज सब मिलके एक सेवालय का भी उपलब्ध कराना बहुत जरूरी है सो ग्रंथालय देवालय सेवालय ये हरेक गांव में होना बहुत जरूरी है वी नीड मोर गुड बुक्स टू एनरिच अवर लाइव्स एंड वी शुड बी अ नेशन दैट रीड्स इट इज विथ ग्रेट कंसर्न आई नोट द डिक्लाइन इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ रीडिंग especially among the young people of our country. With the advent of internet, children now prefer to search for information online rather than rely on books. Even young children now have personal cell phones. Reading books, especially stories, is no longer the norm. Children prefer watching videos online. One major reason is the diminishing attention span in a fast-paced world. Unfortunately, a lot of content available online is of a cursory or superficial nature and does not promote deep reflection and introspection. They give you information, but there is no confirmation. Information with confirmation is more than an ammunition. So you have to read, you have to digest, and you have to acquire knowledge than seeing that there are a number of channels here. No disrespect to them, but making news, breaking news, headline, but their headline should not become a deadline and we should not change our main line. That is only one more information, but the information needs confirmation. This is also very much important. A recent scholarly survey found that only 32% of children read 24 non-academic books annually. This is really troubling, worrying. One of the ways to tackle the problem is to inculcate the habit of reading from very young age, they must be encouraged to look at reading as a fun, as an enjoyment activity rather than a chore. The parents must also serve as role models to their children and read books themselves so that the children may follow the parents. The schools must also actively encourage children to read by setting up reading camps and workshops, by maintaining excellent libraries. They must also take particular care to familiarize children with the lives of great men and make them aware of the glory of India's culture, tangible and intangible heritage. Book fairs like these will introduce to us new books and authors, new literary genres. Book fairs should be conducted in every district at regular intervals to promote reading habit. There is also need to promote quality books in terms of content. The demographic dividend we want to achieve cannot be realized if we don't improve our literacy rate and number of good readers. We need readers and we need leaders who are good. However, it is heartening to note that in spite of growing fear and concern about the future of printed books, the number of book fairs and literary festivals are increasing worldwide. This should be encouraged further. Books have been inspiring hundreds of generations to contribute to the great cause of civilization. But each generation has the sacred duty to acquaint the succeeding generations of the importance of reading and collecting good books. The reading of the books is like a voyage through time, like having a conversation with the finest people who have walked the earth. The wisdom that you gain from these conversations is unparalleled. I hope that this book fair and other similar events all over the country will help mold intelligent, resourceful, creative and compassionate human beings who will build a better nation and a better world. My dear friends, yesterday the nation has celebrated Rashtriya Ekata Divas, of the birth celebrations of the great son of this great country, the unifier of India, Sardar Vallabhai Patel. He not only unified India geographically, but also unified culturally. The life and teachings of people like Sardar Vallabhai Patel, Mahatma Gandhi, Subhash Chandra Bose, and many more like that, our younger generation, they should know. And books should contain more about the life and the sacrifices and the teachings and preachings of the great people who have led the country, who have guided the country, who have worked for the country. They should also be made aware of the social reforms that has taken place from time to time in various parts of the country, including Assam and the northeastern region. The books which are containing the life and the stories of their teachings and preachings, such books should be encouraged very much. That is the need of the hour. Unity. Rashtriya Ekata Divas ka jarurat kya hai? Unity is the need of the hour. That is the main message of Sardar Vallabhai Patel, because he single-handedly, with his wisdom, with his understanding, with his tactful handling, with firmness, he brought all these 565 states together and brought a united India. So it is the duty of the nation to remember such great person. And then Sardar Patel is the person who insisted on having unity. He brought the civil services, IAS, IPS and other All India services to create that unity among the people of the country. So, and also this is an occasion to remember that the Parliament of India, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha, has abrogated Article 370, which has created an artificial barrier between Kashmir and other parts of the country. Kashmir is an integral part of India, and it has happened now, the other day, when the Parliament, has approved this Article 370 abrogation, the real unity also has been achieved. The bill passed by the Parliament are a culmination of the dream seen together by 130 crore population of India. Everybody is rejoicing it. Some people are trying to carry on disinformation campaign. We should be more alert and counter that disinformation campaign. It's an internal matter of India. How do you reorganize your states or districts or administrative blocks is left to the government. We are a constitutionally republic and we are an independent country and we are largest democracy. The Rajya Sabha, where the ruling party do not have majority, has approved with this with 2/3 majority. And the Lok Sabha has approved it 4/5 majority. That shows the overwhelming support the move has. There will be some problems because one of our neighbor continuously troubling, interfering in our internal affairs of our country. They are aiding, abetting, funding, training terrorists and spreading terror, causing unrest. And then diverting our attention. If there is no attention, if there is tension, you cannot pay attention towards development. Peace is the prerequisite. So we must all work together. Stay united. Think united. And shun the forces of divisive nature. Caste, creed, sex, religion, region, these are all there. But we should all think, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one. We are one nation, one people. This has to be the message for all of us. My dear youngsters, please follow your culture, follow your heritage, remember the history of the country, remember the civilization values. Sarve jana sukino bhavantu vasudhaika kutumbakam. The entire world is one family. Share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. So we should all promote it and should not discriminate people on the basis of caste, on the basis of religion, on the basis of region. Whoever is there in this country, all 130 crore people of India, they are our brothers and sisters. We must have the same love and affection towards all of them. This has to be remembered by one and all. That makes our country more strong, more stable. I am happy that this I am able to come here to inaugurate this book fair, and I hope this book fair will promote the reading habit of our youngsters so that they will be able to know the history, they will be able to know development, they will be able to acquire more knowledge and then have more wisdom. That's my wish. I convey my best wishes and I officially declare the book fair open. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.